We have some tension here. Bloomberg's Joe Doe, the United States cannot produce rare earths in the volumes that are required. This is your whole raison d'etre.
Thank you very much for having me. Thank you. And he's exactly right. We don't produce anything in this country at scale that is used in a battery or that is a rare earth. Exactly what he said is applicable to our battery materials. So what Pure Lithium has done is we have invented our way out of this problem. We know that you cannot copy-paste China's lithium-ion battery manufacturing in the U.S. because we don't have the supply chain. China controls graphite, which is the largest component of your lithium-ion battery. At Pure Lithium, we take that and we replace it with lithium metal that can be made from brine, which is all over the smack over in Arkansas and all over the U.S.
Right.
And we pair it with a vanadium cathode that you can source outside of China. There were 28,000 tons of vanadium produced outside of China, and there's a lot in the U.S., a company called U.S. Vanadium, for example. So we just had to invent a better battery that was made with materials that you can actually source outside of China, and that's how you have to get around this problem.
Emily, you're innovating your way out of the problem, but just go back to the problem for a minute. Is there no way we could mine more in the United States in a clean fashion?
Oh, absolutely not. I mean, really take a look at it, what graphite mining is, right? And it's about the natural resources. And it's not even about the mining. It's about the processing of these materials into materials that can be used in a battery, which is a whole nother piece of the supply chain. We also don't do that in the United States. We're just starting to get into mining again in the United States.
Okay, just starting to get back in, and you say basically we shouldn't do anyway, Emily. So let's talk to your innovation. What is it that you've patented, that you've invented, that means we can extricate ourselves from this dependence on China?
Thank you. Well, again, we've leapfrogged. So this lithium metal battery was actually invented by Nobel Prize winner Stan Whittingham at ExxonMobil in 1977. He won the Nobel Prize for the lithium ion battery. Lithium metal battery is a step change in energy density. You can get 400 watt hours a kilogram. You replace the graphite in today's battery with pure lithium metal, and then on the cathode side, you don't need lithium in it. So it opens up a whole suite of opportunities. And we use vanadium in our cathode. So all of this can be made without China. It's a step change in energy density. In our lifetime,
right,
we have had two batteries commercialized past gigawatt hour capacity, lead acid to start your car and lithium ion. And this is the third. And it will displace lithium ion just like lithium ion displaced nickel metal hydride.
Emily.
And it's taken us a while to get here.
What is the cost of your battery on a per unit basis relative to the equivalent from China?
That's a fantastic question. So our battery is 62% less on a materials basis than it is in China. We're looking at about $27 for our battery on a kilowatt hour and materials level. And we should be able to manufacture this battery for substantially less than lithium ion because we don't need these things called formation cycles, which is 35% of CapEx in your lithium ion battery facility.
Okay, so it's cheaper, it's made in the US, seems all a bit of a no-brainer. When can you get to scale in terms of supply here, Emily?
Fantastic question. We're working as hard as we can to build a prototype pilot facility that we're going to send all of our batteries out into the ecosphere. So we're a four-year-old company that was based in Boston, and we've spent the last 4 years doing a tremendous amount of R&D, and we are now scaling up our lithium metal production process from brine and integrating that into a battery manufacturing facility. So we're building this prototype pilot line, and as soon as we get it up and running, we're going to start getting these batteries out into the hands of U.S. customers that need it. And I'm talking to you here from Washington, D.C., trying to make this happen a lot faster.
Who are you speaking to in Washington, D.C., Emily? Who from the administration is supporting you in what you're trying to do?
I think that there is broad support in this administration to have a U.S. domestic supply chain that can produce batteries for our military. We have 30 days of batteries for the military in this country. Stockpile 30 days. That's actually frightening. Think about all of the drones that need 400 watt-hour, a kilogram energy-dense batteries to be able to defend our country. So there's a tremendous amount of support from the administration. We also have a letter of interest from Ex-Im Bank to basically fund our first gigawatt-hour production facility.